My name is Oskar, and I'm a researcher at the WSL and ETH Zürich. I believe that we are witnessing a mass extinction, meaning that there is a quick global decrease in diversity of life forms. I also believe that we humans are in great part responsible for that. In order to coexist with other life forms in a more harmonic way, we still need to understand how the game of life is played. The diversity of life forms found today has intriguing patterns worldwide, which are still not fully understood by scientists. A few questions that occupy my research group colleagues and the entire scientific community are: why do we have so many species in some places and so little in others? Why do some families have a higher diversity than others? What might be the long-term consequences of climate change? And how can we minimize its negative effects? Every species has a particular distribution, and the sum of the species at a given place and time is one way of defining what we call biodiversity. Biodiversity, as we observe today, was not always the same. We know that it has changed over time and space as a result of different interacting processes, such as geological, climatological, biological, and even astronomic, just to name a few. You can grasp now the complexity of these interactions. And to make it even more difficult, the enormous amount of information grows every day. Most of our scientific knowledge tends to progress in a fragmented way, meaning that each discipline focuses more and more into specific topics. This leads to another challenge. How do all these processes play together? My research group and I are trying to have a better glimpse of how these factors interplay and result in past, present, and maybe future biodiversity patterns. To achieve this, we work building models that simulate complex interactions. What is unique in this approach is that we are using mechanistic models. This means that we put together the knowledge from different disciplines and make these processes play together. More specifically, we use information of eco-evolutionary processes, life cycle dynamic, speciation, extinction, growth, dispersion, competition, and genetic mechanisms. All of that taking into account past dynamics of species range, topography, and climate. For this, we need powerful and reliable computers available at the ETH. This innovative approach is promising regarding the dealing with complex systems. Such models are flexible and allow the constant update of our understanding from different sciences. The ultimate goal is to advance our scientific knowledge and to see how biodiversity patterns are formed and changed. Ideally, we will be able to simulate a range of organisms, from boreal forest trees to tropical reef fishes. If we are successful in matching past and present biodiversity patterns, we could even predict some of the long-term effects of climate change. Currently, nature conservation works mainly with pictures of observed biodiversity. However, nature is dynamic, therefore, more like a movie than a picture. By shifting our understanding of nature conservation from a more static towards a more dynamic concept, we consider adaptation and the protection of evolutionary potentials. Doing so, we would better visualize the consequences of the choices we make today, and based on solid knowledge, shape a future that minimizes our impact towards other living beings, or even ourselves if you prefer a less romantic story. Thanks for watching, and I hope to return next time with more interesting findings.